Hello and welcome. The fuckery continues as so far two people have been turned into furniture. Can we make it three by session's end? That is the question. Let's find out. Anton, you have just walked away from Alexander, who was busy hissing at you until you melted his face. How do you wish to proceed?
I didn't walk away. I was trying to speak to him and say, listen, we both know how the beast is. It doesn't listen to us always. That was nothing personal.
This is the crunch.
Yeah, I'm here to put you back right. Huh. So, I'm gonna need you to just relax. Alright, so it's manipulation, medicine, and negative two on that.
Oh, no, 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 no. You... How late... It was right after the blood arrived, right? Epic.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I would say it would be something like three blood points and a dexterity medicine check.
Okay.
Cause lots of fine work. At difficulty nine, and you want three successes or he's gonna come back wrong.
I'm spending willpower on this, I hope you know.
You're really big on making these suddenly really bad.
He just sunk his hands into this fucker's body and rearranged everything, putting back everything as it was so that he doesn't look weird or disproportionate is gonna be tough.
Hmm. I'll buy that.
I have to say, you really do love your higher difficulty rolls.
And honestly, currently his appearance would be at zero and monstrous, and three is the accepted amount of successes for complete success. And difficulty nine does fit for reassembling someone into a person from a chair.
Oh, look at that! One success.
Okay. He didn't botch because he spent willpower. Jekyll.
No, I did. I didn't spend willpower.
You didn't.
I didn't.
You said you did.
I said I'm not spending willpower.
Oh shit.
But it's a failure. I hate you, by the way, Nietzsche. I so hate you.
Well, Quasimodo, you may set your appearance to zero.
I don't think... Well, hold on. I don't...
It's not a botch, so you really can't punish him totally for it.
Yeah, that's not punishing. Not. That's him forming you into a disfigured human-ish thing.
Yeah, your body functions, but your face is half-melted on one side. One of your arms hangs, like, half a foot lower than the other. You are not exactly the vision of beauty at the moment.
You want me to try again?
Yes, you will try again, and you will succeed.
This...
I'm not spending full power.
Is he still at incapacitated? Okay, here's the thing.
I'm not at incapacitated. I was increased to... like,
okay.
Crippled.
Okay. So, Anton. This has taken you more or less half the night.
Also, I'm going to be using up five of my Vitae infusions.
So hold on one second. How did that actually? Was that incredibly painful for him?
I imagine like, so. Probably.
Since he was awake.
Yes, with all likelihood.
I'm sorry, but if flesh crafting people is not incredibly painful, I think we've been playing it wrong.
It's up
no,
to
no,
Izamiti, I would
the
say. It's up to Izamiti if it's painful, but Jackalore doesn't know that. So it's up to you, Nietzsche, if this hurt like a son of a bitch, and if he's now strapped to John Doe, the table, as a nice little specimen, after screaming agony for the past 6 hours.
By the way, I'm pretty sure I'd be able to figure out, considering I could, even if I just heal a single point, I could increase my... I have intelligence of cult of 10 with kindred lores and pretty sure disciplines
Jackal,
are a part of kindred lore.
You are strapped to a table while he's working. You are not in a position to take advantage of the Vita infusions at that time.
Yes, actually, I would be, because it only requires a single word.
You can't put them in your mouth, because first you don't
have your I'm pretty sure they are. It states that they are mystically imbued into your body.
No, they're not. They're pieces of metal you carry around.
Dun, dun, dun.
No, they aren't made of metal.
Oh my gosh.
Dude, you haven't read the description of ritual? It's my favorite level 2 ritual. I have read it. I know how it works.
Mm-hmm. It does state that you can do more than just metal, but usually you do use like pennies or something for it because they're very common.
Yeah.
Does it say the size of a penny?
Yes. That's the minimum. Essentially, you have a necklace of shiny, jingly, blood-red, glistening, metal-y things that are filled with blood, which you have to actually put in your mouth to use.
I mean, let's put it this way. You can get 100 pennies for a dollar. It's a lot. And it puts some kind of use for pennies.
So no, Jackalord, you wouldn't be able to do this. So, Anton, did this hurt like a son of a bitch?
Yes, it sure did.
And did you help him put the blood in his mouth afterwards?
Yeah, sure.
So?
You look down on him. You're pretty sure this is some of your finest work. This would scar a child for life.
It's a good thing I'm completely inhuman.
He would know that the Ductus would not appreciate this, so he's going to try to put him right.
Spend the rest of the night trying to improve his appearance?
Sure, we can do that. Because I like doing that too.
Okay, Jackalore. You can see from the expression of his face that he's not pleased with the result. He's about to start again. On a side note, because you like the meta so much, right now, your difficulties to intimidate people are at a -1 difficulty.
You could not probably currently walk in any kind of way in the outside world.
But that's a minor thing, right?
It actually doesn't specify that it has to be metal. It says an object.
That's what I said, but pennies are one of the most common penny-sized things.
I don't think
yes,
was...
I could also take small pieces of stone.
I
you
think
could.
It was metallic, but it might
no,
have
it says
been
object.
In R3.
Mm-hmm. It doesn't specifically say it needs to be metallic. It actually just specifies size more than anything. But still, I don't get why you wouldn't do pennies, especially if you could just put them on like a little necklace or something, man.
I wouldn't understand either. I'm just pointing out that it doesn't have to be pennies.
Okay, I suppose it doesn't.
I think pennies are cool. Look, I got a penny.
I don't like pennies. Pennies are annoying.
You can drill a hole in them and put them on a necklace. It's like
Jackalore wants to make them out of his own toenails. He pulls them off and regrows them and infuses them with blood. Don't judge him.
Is that really what he does?
I never said anything about toenails. I said stones was the only thing I said about that.
Okay, I was about to say. That's
it could be small rocks.
Look, I think the toenail thing's pretty cool, too.
Yes, it's cool and all, but it's completely and totally impractical and completely and totally stupid.
You have somebody remove your heart once a week and then cut that into little pieces so that you have something to remember yourself by.
You guys are completely and totally batshit crazy.
Meanwhile, there's a knock on the front door, Satan, while they are working on someone's appearance. Hello, is Alexander in?
Baking goods?
See, it's been 3 weeks and he wanted to learn thaumaturgy, and I can't just sit on my ass while he finally decides to learn. I have things I need to do for my back, so thought I would talk to him, maybe get started finally, you know?
I thought I had him do that earlier already.
One moment. Go back to the other people.
Satan, you see Alexander teeth gritted in pain, looking very much like Quasimodo, and on his tongue sticking out the corner of his mouth, is very engrossed in rearranging Alexander's face ever so slowly. No, let's just turn this. Okay. And it's symmetrical, sort of. That kind of a thing. Also, Alexander is currently strapped on his back to John Doe, who is still at table.
The imagery. That's so good. That's so good.
You are very much making me consider the whole not killing you part, by the way.
I'm sorry. I'm just playing the way he's supposed to be played.
How does Satan react to this scene?
Nietzsche, remind me again how you're not at three points of health from aggravated damage.
I forget. Hold on. Let me see. I am.
What is your normal dice on that?
My normal dice on what?
On dex medicine. Okay, you did lower it. Because if that had gone down lowered by two, that would have sucked for Jackalore, because that would have been a 3-point botch. Epic, are you muted by chance? Epic?
Are you okay?
We are not hearing you being awesome right now.
I said be right back.
Oh, okay. I was like, oh god, he died at his desk.
Quick, leak him blood!
Yeah, sorry. My family suddenly wanted me to come look at some. It was an April Fool's joke.
Wow, they're late. They're late.
I did for a moment consider accusing you of shooting blues in Providence, Epic, but fuck it all. Not worth the effort. Fuck April Fools. Right. Stupid thing. Did you at least catch the imagery I painted for you as you walked in on the basement?
Nope. Oh. I left immediately after I said that. On the other hand, you know what? I'm gonna start practicing Auspex so that whenever you think I'm ready, I'll just spend it on the third dot.
Okay.
So, Litten!
What are you trying to see?
Just looking at auras.
Okay. You see that Anton is very caught up in his work. You are not sure he has even registered that you are there. He's slowly rearranging Alexander's face, and Alexander is still strapped to John the table. Alexander does not look very happy at this news.
So I am letting Lynn in, right? That was what I was going to do.
You can let him in.
He's following me downstairs, right?
If you left the door open as you walked off, he would have followed you, yes.
Yeah, you didn't make any specifications.
Yeah, I know. As I said, I left immediately right after I talked.
Oh, what is... Okay.
I'm guessing Anton will be stopping temporarily.
Anton See? Doesn't give
Bread.
A fuck.
Apparently not.
Anton,
this is a bakery. We are making
bread.
Should
I roll to see people here?
Roll perception alertness at 5.
Oh gosh, I only got 2 dice in that.
He
is at literally... No, he's almost at literally the lowest he could.
He's like, huh? Oh, he's like, oh, hi.
Hey. Say it, peanut butter.
Oh. Wait, peanut butter? You have some? I didn't know you're peanut butter. I didn't think you made this place stick.
What would you like, priest?
It's that one.
He's not finished yet.
Yeah. He seeks knowledge.
He seeks knowledge.
I think I should go. He starts slowly backing up the stairs. Oh, no,
don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. He'll be finished here in a minute.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay. You can wait.
I think you'll be needing a little more than that.
If you'd continue,
that would be great.
It can talk and walk and... I'm not sure about think, but maybe.
Wow. God darn you.
We let it be up to him. Would you be all right with this form for now, Ductus?
No.
No?
You should be able to take just a couple seconds and talk to Lynn. And
I stand up. Walk over to Lynn.
You're still tied to the table.
Okay.
Yeah, you're still tied to the table. I was just saying talk.
If I could undo the bonds, that would be very, very much appreciated.
I untie him.
He looks you up and down. And does, well, this is new.
Huh?
Oh, what is that bulge? Oh, God.
If you're done with your compliments, I would very much like to ask you why you are here. By the way, I healed my aggravated, not my aggravated, my away from crippled, since, you know, that's kind of necessary to walk around.
Well, you're the one who wanted to learn how to throw fire.
Yes, I'll be doing that as soon as Anton over there is done with his little fun.
Oh, this is no longer fun for me. You're okay.
It was tons of fun.
I would like should he be having role manipulation subterfuge? Because I'm sure he enjoys it a lot.
Should I?
You probably should, because that is part of your character.
That is true.
Because you just said that fleshcrafting people isn't fun.
But I'm not even going to roll.
It was
not
the fleshcrafting part. I think I'd find it more entertaining for you to walk around in this form for a little while, actually. That's what I was going with.
Yeah, but you also really enjoy it.
Yeah, he's right. So we'll go with that.
Lynn goes, listen. I have things to do, Alexander, and in all honesty, just please dial down the attitude, will you? I'm the one who's offering to teach you something useful here. Just don't be a dick about it. Seriously.
Apologies. He can't stop. He won't stop.
Yes, I'm sorry for my attitude. It's been very straining to be straining lately.
So, how the fuck did this even happen? Is the
misunderstanding
table...
between me and Anton?
Is that table John?
Yes. Apparently they also had a misunderstanding.
The beast is unleashed. Wait.
Yeah, I frenzied. Couldn't be helped.
See. He steps by. Well, I'm sure that you would appreciate being part of a real pack, not like he just waves his hand at these. So why don't you come by? You can talk to Sally.
Are you talking to me?
Yes, he really is. He just steps past Alexander, completely ignoring the two of them at this point.
Oh God!
Can I attempt to roll my presence too now on him? Because I'd very much like to do that.
Are you saying, I am not a good pack mate?
You are a good pack mate. That's what I say. Because
I was talking to Lynn.
Lynn just... I would say you're the best here other than Anton, because apparently you managed not to get turned into furniture. Somehow.
Okay. I guess I'm all right with that.
Don't mind. I'm going to... take the time to, fix John. Well, I'm gonna need some blood first. He'll wait. And I walk out of the room.
Leaving Alexander in his current state.
He needs to learn.
Like it.
I'm doing.
You know, I'm very much reconsidering the whole not killing you part now.
Don't worry.
You wanted to learn this. I'll fix you eventually.
You'll be making plenty of willpower rolls anyway.
Alright, so, Lynn just goes, he's gone,
yep, Baker left.
So really, he, you and the Gangrel, really?
He got lucky.
I'm
pretty sure that's a factually correct statement.
He traces a finger over John's skin, which is stretched across the surface of the table. I'm not sure that this is luck. Entirely. And I can hear someone clicking away as well.
He's decent people, but he's going to need punishment. He wasn't able to help them. Ductus. What happened?
Well, apparently Anton decided that he wanted to do something. Also, I'll be eating the rest of my Vitae infusions now, Chris.
All right, yeah, I gave you 15, I think.
10, actually.
No, actually, he said 15. I swear.
Yeah.
Really?
Okay. Yeah. How much blood is in the barrel? How much blood is in the barrel?
I think we got it. Yeah, you drank it all.
That's what I thought.
I think we drank all for the night.
Honey.
Yeah.
Well, I have 5 left then. And I'll be healing myself up.
Mm-hmm. Wait, don't we have farm animals around?
No, you really don't.
I'll be taking 3 more out of 2 Vitae
infusions. For some reason, I thought we had cattle. I don't know why I thought that. Or there were cattle nearby.
That's because Jack O'Neill got gored by a rampaging bull.
That's probably it. So, where was that at? Is that not near us?
No, not really. Good ways downriver.
Okay, never mind then.
Yeah, he's just trying to get blood. A cow.
cow would have a lot of blood.
Yeah, there is, of course, that one issue of most vampires. You didn't happen to select animal ken, did you?
Yes, I did.
Oh my gosh, you're all right.
He can attempt to roll manipulation, subterfuge, or the cow with his animalism to try and seduce it.
Nice. Well, I am from Tennessee.
Wouldn't that be, wouldn't that be appearance subterfuge?
He doesn't look like a cow. It's gonna count as appearance zero either way.
You don't look at all appetizing. Six successes later.
Listen, I have to tell you a horrible secret. The farmer, he's raising you for your meat.
That's a good one. Yeah, I like that. He's taking your... He takes your babies away, uses your milk that you make for your babies get eaten. And then, when you can't make milk anymore, he turns you into hamburger.
It's great that you get animalism, right?
All right, look, I should let y'all continue, because I don't have a lot of time, and I want to see where this gets.
All right. Oh. So, you having fun?
Out of character, who's he asking?
Both.
Sure.
But yes, you can begin teaching me. I will wait here. I go over to the closet and open enters the library. If you'd please enter.
He steps inside. Don't take this the wrong way, but do you have a paper bag you could put over your head?
No.
I'll go get one!
I'm gonna roll manipulation subterfuge. Okay. It sounds fucking perfect. You have no idea he's deliberately trolling you.
Oh, good. Did I get to roll before I left?
Yeah, you can roll perception empathy on that. Your specialization on perception at least would apply, I think. So.
Also, good judge of character. Yay, I think this counts.
Sure. You know. You know.
And he still went to go get a bag.
He's in on the joke.
Okay.
I hate all of you.
A few minutes later, Satan returns with a paper groceries bag with two holes cut out for the eyes.
I brought it!
I take it and I put it in my pocket and I continue into the library.
I'll just do two thumbs up at Lynn.
Lynn just looks at you and whispers, "Should I dominate him to put it on?"
It sounds like a pretty decent idea for fun.
Lynn calls out to Alexander, "Hey, Alexander!
What is it?" Without turning around, still walking.
Do you know what this is?
Turn around? Yes.
Okay.
You do?
What's your current willpower?
Yes, questioningly.
What's your current willpower?
Current willpower, I think that's 7.
I think you spent one, didn't you?
Maybe. Yes, more. I have 9. No, that's 6 right now.
He says in a strangely compelling voice, "Put on the bag, please."
Do I have to?
Well, kinda, yeah.
God damn it. I hate you guys. I hate you guys so much.
What you guys
doesn't say anything about taking off the bag. I put the bag
it
on.
It'll barely last that time, but you will have to put it on.
Yes, put it on. And 10 seconds later, you go, wait a second.
I take it off. if you weren't going to teach me something, I would very much be. You would very much be leaving right now.
I approve. Wait, not that part. I approved. He makes a weird hand gesture.
Puts
down his hand.
Sure, let's get started. Now, I'm gonna roll Intelligence Occult for Lin to see if he is able to explain this in any sensible way. He is.
I would have allowed him to use the occult library for bonus, but whatever.
No, this is about him remembering his own thing, not research. So.
Yeah, remember, a cult library really counts for things that you can research and spend quite a bit of time on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. This is him accessing his own know-how, essentially.
Yay.
So yeah, you start learning. Does Satan stick around and try to gain the secrets of thaumaturgy?
He's not really trying to gain the secrets of thaumaturgy so much as he's gaining the secrets of people.
Alright.
You! Show me all your secrets, both of you.
Niche, in case you need to leave at some point, roll secretly to me the roll for fixing John. So I know.
That was on Alexander.
Okay, good to know. Thank you, Niche.
And I suppose I'll just do some insight stuff in order to figure out what might or might not be happening in people's plans involving these two.
Just general where the webs go?
Whoops. Yeah.
Mm.
Hit the wrong one on that one. Oh, well.
Okay.
I'm not sure if you want me to roll for both or just that one is alright.
No, just make a general roll. That one will do. Okay.
Alright.
General plans.
Yeah, I'm not looking for anything specific, just basically anything that could be a threat to the pack.
Mm-hmm. Okay. You see far off in the distance in an ivory tower a large bearded man. Annoyed at the buzzing flies of Toluca, who are interfering with him in annoying ways. Not really harming him, but gods would he love to smack them if they gave him an opportunity. And what else? What else would be... Well, you see your own Sabbat elders plotting... Yanking on their marionettes, looking for ways to exploit the resources of Toluca and to use the packs here for their own advantage in the war against the Cammarilla and for harnessing resources in general.
Mm-hmm.
And you see further down the highway a small Cammarilla town who had a bus full of... Actually, no. Yeah, you did drive the bus over there.
Yes, a certain someone drove the bus over there.
Who had a bus full of corpses driven over to them, and who had a major masquerade breach, and who have for the past month or so been trying to clean it up, slowly turning their gazes outwards, looking for who the fuck pulled that bullshit on them.
All right. So it looks like the major threat from vampires and everything is currently that city, that little town over there.
Could be.
Yarr.
It would be comparable in size to Toluca, so you're mostly would be dealing something like a population of 20, maybe 30 vampires if it's really highly populated. So in theory,
so probably not too terrible when they attack us, but they're gonna be able to send some kind of group.
Well, what you do is send ghouls with gasoline and burn the town down. Blame it on a riot, right?
Well, I was going to cause a riot, but...
Well, you caused one already, right?
Well, not over there, I don't think.
Ah, you mean there. Huh. Interesting. Interesting.
They think they control this town? I'll show them.
Alright. So where...
I'm just kidding.
So where
he doesn't think that
well. Anton head after they settle down to study and, well, Satan goes off into the never land of his visions.
That's a good place.
I'm gonna call my contact and
Which one?
The one I called Bob previously, but we've yet to rename.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Say something more imaginative this time.
I think I'm going to let you stay that way.
Please say Stan or something.
Anton, is that you?
Yeah.
The fuck, Anton?
Look, I'm probably going to have to find another place to do this at. I don't think these people are cool at all. Yeah, I'm sorry about that. We had a bit of a squabble, me and them.
Listen, Anton, I don't know what kind of strange cult you're involved with, but you should be careful. People like these, they can do things. You should get away from them.
Well, I appreciate the concern.
I love how non sequitur this entire conversation is.
Look, I still want to do this, and I still want to make a little money on the side with this project, but it looks like I'm going to have to find another place to really put my roots in. And I might need some help, you know, from some person. Probably an assistant of some sort.
Oh, Anton. Come on,
I can probably find my own.
You can't keep asking for favors without giving us something in return. It's all well and good to promise a ocean of drugs later on, but you know.
Well, I see your point. Tell you what, why don't you just give me like a little sample of something, and I'll see what I could whip up with just what I have on hand. Maybe that'll be good enough.
I'm not going to meet that one guy at the door again, right? Never would.
I'll meet him.
Would a master's level student of chemistry be able to just cook up drugs with whatever without a specific recipe he has been instructed in?
It depends. Is he specifically chemistry?
Yes, he is.
Yeah, definitely then, because... all it really is taking on the various chemical formulas and transforming them into the correct, you know, other chemical formulas. I hated chemistry. I admit it.
Yes, I hated it too. But I'm a chemist now.
So I get the idea on why it is actually pretty simple, but goddamn, you have to memorize so much stuff.
All right. Fair enough. Okay. You know the fracking formulas, right? Why don't you just cook something up? We'll feed it to some of the local junkies, form a focus group, and just have test it on the local clientele. See what happens.
Yeah, I would just add like a +2 difficulty for not having a very specific thing.
Well, we did have a specific thing. It was going to be kind of like a hallucinogen, but with this, I'd probably just find way to make like amphetamine.
Mm-hmm. All right, so what do you want to do?
Just
cook some meth?
Do meth, but yeah, sure. That'd probably be something that they have in the, he probably has something in his house somewhere that I could use. His ghouls might have, like, stuff.
That's actually what I was really thinking of when I said add plus two to the difficulty for not having the materials on hand.
Yeah, you do not have a chemistry set in here.
Right.
You would have to improvise one entirely from dinnerware, most likely. And you certainly don't have all the chemical crap for methamphetamine either. You would have to go raid the local stores to get all the chemical ingredients as well, because you wouldn't have everything on hand.
Which is why I suggested just making something rather random and basing his successes on what it might have been, just on what's on hand and improvised tools and all that shit.
Well, can I see what I got? What you have on hand is essentially cleaning supplies and some gasoline, and that's it. This place isn't
really...
have
any...
Yeah, it's not really brimming with chemicals.
Yeah, that's...
anything like medicine anywhere? Because he had, had a ghoul.
He did have a ghoul, but they don't stay here.
Okay.
Not generally.
Yeah, the ghouls lasted about a week each, I think. So, no. Not really, no.
Not only that, anything they did have probably wouldn't be quite enough to do too much with. You really need to go and raid. You need to go raid either.
I know what I'm going to do.
All right.
I'm going to go out and look for a hooker.
Okay. Okay. Roll me a perception streetwise to find hookers.
Oh, I have no streetwise. Oh, that sucks.
I'm glad you're starting to realize shit.
So, it's perception.
At what difficulty?
Roll at 6 with your one die. As you hobble down the street calling, Hooker! Hooker!
Right.
You're terrible at getting your dice right, man.
Yeah. Sorry.
Well, the first one, in theory, is an 8.
The last one is, in theory, a 1. Why don't we take the last one?
We did say that we would roll from the start with the proper amount of dice when we fuck things up. That is
re-roll.
Yeah, re-roll. There you go.
Okay. Right. You hear a, well, hello there, sugar. As you turn around, you see what looks vaguely like a female troll covered with a thick... thick layer of makeup. Don't worry, darling. It appears to be somewhat old as well. Lucy here will take care of you. Come here, darling.
Hey, how about we go back to your place?
Oh, we don't need a place. Just step here in this alley.
Not exactly interested. Sorry.
You're good at talking people into things, right?
Oh yeah, I probably could. Look, we will go back to your place.
Okay. Sure, you seem like a nice guy. That was to detect, by the way, that you are a horrible evil monster and not really human or alive at all. Oh my,
okay.
Are you a hunter? Look at those claw marks. Mm-hmm. I love a man with scars.
Yes, I like it a little rough.
There's nothing wrong with this man at all.
Nothing at all. So how would you like to proceed as she leads you upstairs to a dingy apartment?
I'm just going to follow her in.
All right.
I do have to warn you. Don't get in a fight. I have a suspicion she's strength-based.
All right, so are we in the apartment now?
Yes, you are.
What does it look like?
It looks dirty, like it hasn't been properly taken care of for quite a while now.
Does she look kind of like, does, okay, hold on a second. Does it look like is it an apartment or is it a hotel room? That's what I guess I'm wondering. Is it an actually live-in space, or is she in a
No, it's
hotel?
An apartment, but it's like a really run-down, dingy kind. It's like
okay.
The kind of, essentially a slum building.
All right.
Look, if you're lucky, it's Slumdog Millionaire time.
I don't know what that means.
I don't either.
You son of a...
I've seen the movie, too. I'm just, like, drawing a blank.
Whisper
oh, okay.
to me how I should fuck him, Epic.
Oh, don't worry. His one success is fuckery enough. you know what that means.
I'm gonna
turned
go to
out she was clean.
I'm gonna ask her, like, can I use your restroom real quick?
Sure, honey. I'll be right here waiting for you. She pats the bed suggestively.
Okay, I'm going to go into the bathroom.
Okay, you go into the bathroom. The toilet could use a good scrubbing.
I'm going to look around for medication.
Okay.
Or anything.
Look for perception investigation to find drugs.
Okay, but can I... I'm going to spend a willpower point.
All right.
Yeah, that giggle makes me realize that I'm not going to find anything, am I? Is that what this is? Anything. I could find anything, really. If she has, like, anything.
Well, then roll for it.
Okay.
Okay. You don't find any actual drugs. But you do find some cold medicine and some other stuff that you could use as... It would bring you closer on your quest to find ingredients for meth. It's some of the things you can use.
You basically just got some over-the-counter
yes.
pill bottles,
that's what
man.
For.
Yes,
that's
exactly.
What for. Okay, I stuffed that stuff in my pocket.
All right. How do you
and
proceed?
I just start to leave.
Okay, go out into the apartment, head for the door. Hey, wait, where are you going?
I changed my mind.
Oh, you stop right there, young man. She rushes after you. She's now rushing down the stairs behind you, naked. How would you like to proceed as you are?
Does he have to roll willpower or get a derangement from that?
Probably not, sadly, but...
Aw...
Nah, I just walk out and leave.
Anton, you are gonna get grappled, I believe, as she rushes behind you. She can easily catch you due to the simple fact that you are very much still mauled, I believe, or wounded. Would you like to dodge?
Oh, is there any way I could use brawl to dodge? Or do I just gotta use dexterity?
Not for a grapple. If she was trying to hit you in the face with a fist, you could say block, and then you could use brawl, but no.
Which brawl? How much brawl do you have?
One.
then probably not. If you had more and something like a martial arts specialization, I would probably let you troll her instead, you know?
That sounds pretty cool.
But I'm not sure that with one brawl that's really applicable.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, she's at me in a grapple.
Okay. She attempts to do strength damage. She says in your ear, "You haven't paid me for my time."
Maybe she's stamina based.
So I guess that's how much damage she did.
It's all right if I'm trying to semi metagame a random NPC, right?
Yeah, it's fine in theory.
I'm just thinking it's pretty funny to just try and figure out, hey, where'd her points go in this?
I'm gonna take control of the grapple.
All right. Okay, then roll for that. Oh no, you don't, you little bitch! Get upstairs and pay me!
Are those my pills?
Fine, let's go.
Let's roll perception alertness. Actually, no, we did say that she had 3 dice in that, so let's re-roll that. I forgot we could already establish that. What's that in your pocket, young man?
Are you happy to see me?
No, clearly he isn't, because if he had been, he would have stayed.
You're right, let's go back to your apartment. Come on. I got money.
Okay, she stands up behind you and shoves you in the back like, get up the stairs. I love how you keep getting screwed by random no-sheet NPCs. It's awesome. Jackalore almost got downed by a farmer and his trusty six-shooter. Anton is being bullied by a...
Are we in her apartment now?
Yes, sure. You go back up.
I reach into my pocket.
Mm-hmm.
And I put money on the counter.
Roll dexterity at difficulty 7.
Why?
Reasons. Please fail this.
Well, of course I'm going to fail it. I got 2 dice.
Go ahead. Impress me.
Does that include your
yes, it does. Your... Roll. Okay. Okay, her medicine cabinet's contents go rolling all over the floor. Rise went. Oh no, you didn't!
Baby, I have a problem.
For cold medicine?
Just fleshcraft her into oblivion. She won't notice.
Just. Oh, look, you seem like a nice lady. Let me just do something for you here.
Okay, what
and
do
I
you...
grab her. I grab her face and I flesh. I do malleable, whatchamacallit, to make it look scarred.
She's gonna attempt to dodge as you try to grab her face. So make a dex brawl.
Oh gosh.
Okay.
It's all right. It's all right. You got her.
Alright.
So I scar up her face.
Okay, she goes, yeah! As you carve up her face.
I'm going to grab her arms now.
Okay, she's still trying to fight you off and resist. It's not very effective.
Grab her arms, and I'm going to bone craft them.
Alright, what are you trying to
do
with
them? To break them. I'm just going to go break.
Okay, that arm. Would be probably a difficulty 4 if you're just trying to disable them. 7 if you're trying to inflict actual damage and rupture the skin and just fuck her up in general. Alright, her arms are very much useless. She is seeing what is happening to her arms and feeling the pain. She starts screaming at the top of her lungs.
I am a monster.
Oh god.
Good thing to know, oh, right?
Yeah.
No, so you're just a killer.
I'm just gonna kill her. I'm just gonna... Yeah, I think it's best.
Okay, what do you do?
Punch her in the face? just see if I can kill her? Like that way?
Well, keep in mind that both of those uses of fleshcraft would have taken a blood point each, I think.
Yeah, I know. I'm noting it down.
Excellent.
I'm very thirsty. So
you're just going to punch her in the face?
You know what? No. I'm going to change that to... I'm going to... grapple her. Or I still have her arms held, right? So I'm going to feed on her.
I would say that... Yeah. When you fleshcraft someone, that's just to hit and grab hold. Your arms are busy actually doing the fleshcrafting, so you wouldn't maintain a grapple while doing that, generally speaking.
So I'm going to get her in a grapple.
Alright, she's going to attempt to dodge. She does not get to use her stuff. Okay.
Well, that's not good. I hear you laughing.
Okay.
That didn't work.
She goes screaming out the door and down the stairs. Would you like to hobble along with your limited movement speed due to wounds?
You might want to ignore wound penalties.
I don't have enough willpower.
You know, I might just kill you. Just saying.
You hear a yelp? But you do not hear a duck, duck, duck as she goes slamming down the narrow staircase. So apparently she survived the passage down.
Okay, I do run after her. And I will use my willpower to ignore wind penalties.
So how's that working for your cold, methodical, scientific nature? Are things controlled and logical so far?
Not yet.
Will they ever be?
Okay.
Probably not.
Make me a dex roll to see if you can catch her. You need 3 successes on this. Okay, ooh. You catch her and pull her into a grapple.
Trainer.
There's always now just one issue. It's a very unfortunate one. I'm sure he's thinking about it. Don't worry about it.
I am. I think I am.
Not you. No, you're not.
I'm thinking about this issue.
If you were, you wouldn't be where you are right now.
I wouldn't have made her scream if I wasn't thinking about screwing him in that way, Epic.
Yeah. That was a lot of screaming.
But she's in a derelict hotel, apartment, so...
That just means it's not very well repaired.
Yes. There's people living here. Ye old and washed masses.
I'm going to drain her.
Okay. Nobody interferes with you as you drain her.
People are watching.
You are busy enjoying the blood. You would not necessarily be able to tell.
Okay.
This is why not finding the right target, nor having any real way to stealthily get her in the right place, and then
not even just biting her so she's in bliss and can't even tell what's going on.
You should have killed her first, is what Epic is saying.
Yeah, thought so. And I tried to.
No, you didn't. You tried to get out.
Oh, well,
which, like right. Any reasonable person, she decided to chase the guy that suddenly went into her bathroom and immediately left.
I was thinking she was a cop. Didn't want to kill a cop, dude. That's why I was asking all these questions about what the apartment looked like.
Okay.
All right. So how much blood do I get out of her?
You can get 10 points.
Booyah. How many people saw?
You have no idea.
I'll say this. It would have actually been much funnier if she was a cop, because then that would have turned out even better in some ways if you'd left her alive and just bit her. Mm-hmm. You failed in your duty. You're supposed to just be undercover, you son of...
But he was so attractive. Oh.
It was the greatest night ever.
Okay. So, it's time to,
God damn it, Lucy, this is the fifth time! This is your final warning, stop sleeping with the targets!
Sorry,
I'm derailed. I think I've something out here. I'm looking around to see if there's, any way I could start a fire.
Alright. Alright. The staircase would probably be... It wouldn't necessarily be wood, would it? It would be some sort of a building
wood
material. Probably.
Mm-hmm. I'm thinking more like electrical.
Well, you can see the lights in the ceiling and, in general, just... Well, there's electric lights. At least.
Can I use my my technology and intelligence to see if I know a way to like start a fire on hand?
I'm not sure that you would with just one technology. I'll let you roll for it at difficulty 8 to improvise something if you wish.
It's not that hard to start an electrical fire, trust me.
Yeah, it doesn't seem like... At the very least, I feel like I can just shove something into a socket.
If you're looking to make sure that it's spreads quickly enough and is set in such a way to actually consume the body and burn down enough of the building to hide all the evidence, then yes, it would be that difficulty. Just starting a flame, yes, that would be relatively easy. But setting it in such a way that it isn't stopped or burn itself out before it does enough damage is a different matter, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Anyway, as Nietzsche tries to figure out how to commit arson, let's split the recording.